We are here and we're getting all the information about the Real Husbands of Hollywood, about tonight's reunion, and about the season premiere.
Absolutely.
Season 3, guys.
That's right, Mitches. Kev is back. This is the
love, this is the love. Boris came back.
Hey, well, I'm better than Nelly.
Hey, I don't see nobody else at this table who had a meeting with Scorsese.
Jackie, get your straight to DVD movie ass up off the floor. You overacting.
From the looks of it, it looks like it's gonna be pretty crazy.
It's absolutely.
I mean, it's already crazy.
I was gonna say the show is crazy already. We're already resting at about an 8.5, 9. This one is at 11. It's out of control. We still have even on our reunion special, we have some amazing guest star action happening, which we can't have any RHOH without having some amazing guest star stuff going on.
Of course.
And all the guys are in not even rare form, but just in average form. They're just doing what they do, being crazy, being ridiculous, starting some fights.
He is a world-class ass, wait for it, ho.
See, I had to separate it because you can't say those words together on BET.
So yeah, it's gonna be wild and I can't believe it's tonight. I can't believe it's-
You're gonna see some like actual fist fighting because on reality TV shows, the reunion, it's not a reunion unless somebody gets slapped.
Unless someone gets slapped, you know? Or there's some drinks thrown, or I mean nowadays, unless somebody's getting arrested. I mean seriously, it is no longer enough to just get a good punch in. We gotta take somebody away in cuffs.
Right, so this is what we're expecting then on the reunion.
I don't know if anyone gets arrested,
okay,
but maybe. I can't recall, but I think that there might have been some security called at least.
I would say that just makes it so much more interesting because you do what you want to do and you guys have fun while you're doing it, obviously. And it comes out awesome.
Yes, and I mean, you know, I think in the beginning we all were a little, you know, unsure of how that would play out. Mm-hmm. But the audience has been so fantastic at receiving what we're doing and just really running with us with whatever we do, going, yeah, I'll buy that. It's fun, but it is, like you said, a little crazy.
Yeah.
Because what happens on our show is that whatever the first take is, I guarantee you, the 10th take is probably gonna be what we keep. Because on the first take, it's something crazy, and then it's, oh, we just go with that, do that, and more. And then the next take is, do that more, but on your head.
I'm kind of curious about that. During the takes, can you give us like kind of a behind the scenes look of something that crazy did happen, where they, just tell us where it started from, and kind of where it ended.
Oh gosh, all right, let's talk about the reunion special because that's what's coming up sooner. I don't wanna even take a chance of talking about anything else and then ruining anything. You know, so on the reunion special, I'd say, there was a lot of, what started as bringing the ladies out, which is always where some drama begins. We bring the ladies out.
Does a weave get thrown across the-
There's definitely gonna be a weave. I think whenever we have Tisha on the show, there's a weave joke running.
Ow, she don't look good.
There's at some point Kevin is on the floor and there's a woman on top of him. I don't know which woman it is. It might be his ex-wife. It might be a new girlfriend.
Oh, man.
It might be Salida changing her mind. I'm not really sure.
But it just started out like just sitting down, bantering back and forth, and then everyone's on the floor.
Ladies, lots of the ladies turn into vicious women very quickly.
Oh, man. Who's been your favorite so far that you've been able to work with on the show?
I have to say that my favorite to work with was Wayne Brady, because Wayne Brady plays my beau this year. And so I have to be, I have to say that, because I get to love up on him and he gets to love up on me. And
like, you need some love on the show.
I'm excited about seeing Snoop Lion. I'm excited about that. Because I was not on set that day.
What is his role on the show?
I have no idea. I have no idea what he's doing. I just want to know how high he's going to be. That's what I want to know. I'm gonna go ahead and say it because wasn't there that day and I'm just curious, were they able to get anything like audible out of him or was it all in just rhyme? Was it all just, what's up my nizzle in the hizzle with your hair rizzle, looking good with your mic hizzle? I used every one of my last favors to get you the Oscars back and you know what you did? You did what you always do, Kevin, you f***ed it up.
Well, wait a minute, yuck mouth.
Outside of, you know, the show and everything, what's one thing maybe people don't know about you?
I box. Like, ooh, I'm a, nice. I box. I've been looking for a long time for, like, a workout. As a woman, you know, it sucks. You always want to be in that gym, but you hate the gym. You don't want to go. You have to go. What do?
So we're going to knock out Kevin on season 3 using
all about, guys. I have been doing this boxing for a year and a half just so I can get a full-on, like, boom, on there. Everybody gets to knock somebody out on this show except me. I want to knock out Kevin. It's my campaign. That's why I have the IG going. I need everybody to get online. I need you to go ahead and, like, petition for Cynthia to get, Trina, to get a full-on knockout. I'm going to say, wait, I can't do this. because he's more down here. So it can't be like a full, we're gonna have to come down and then boom, uppercut, bam.
I love it. You guys better stay
or
tuned for
like
season 3.
Or like a Donkey Kong, like full just punch, kinda. Like a.
I'm watching season 3 just because I want to watch her knock him out. City where we party up.